Good morning, students. So, in previous classes, we discussed regarding the questions associated with VTU examinations. So, now we just continued remaining questions. So, in this particular class, we will discuss a few questions associated with Visveshwaraya Technological University question paper, semester 1, engineering mechanics, that is elements of civil engineering and engineering mechanics. This particular problem is associated with parallelogram law of forces. So, the question is, two locomotive moving on opposite banks of canal. So, there are, it's a locomotive, it's moving opposite banks of canal by means of two forces. Can pull the vessel, this is a vessel, it's a pulling force. So, parallel to the banks by means of two ropes, that is two ropes P and Q, or 20 kN and 24 kN. While total angle between them, so the angle between P and Q is 60 degrees, is given in the problem. Find the resultant pull. We have to determine what is the R value. Find resultant pull. What is R value? Resultant. Find the resultant pull. And also on the vessel, also find the angle alpha and beta is given. The angle alpha and beta with respect to x-axis. Alpha is the inclination of Q force. Beta is the inclination of P force. We have to determine alpha is how much and beta is how much. So, the figure is given in the question paper itself. So, now we move on to what is parallelogram law of forces. So, write the equation of parallelogram law. By parallelogram law. What is the equation of resultant? R square equals P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos alpha. But in this case, we will take it as alpha dash, where alpha is, we know that alpha is the angle between P and Q. But here it is denoted as alpha dash. Therefore, alpha dash, cos alpha dash. So now we know the P value, we know Q value, we know alpha dash value. We can directly determine resultant value. Therefore, because we know that P equals 24 kN and Q equals 20 kN and alpha dash equals 60 degrees. Therefore, substitute these values in the resultant equation. Therefore, R square equals P square, that is 24 square plus Q square, 20 square plus 2 into 24 into 20 into cos 60 degrees, alpha dash is 60 degrees. So what is R square value? Determine R square value.
1456.
Take the square root, you are getting R. R equals
38.15 kilonewton.
This is the resultant pull acting on the vessel. So this is one part. We determine the resultant pull. So, this is resultant pull. Now, we have to determine, also find the angles alpha and beta. We have to determine the angles alpha and beta. So, we know that where theta is the inclination of one of the resultant force with respect to x-axis. So, as per equation, we know that is theta equals tan inverse of magnitude of q sine alpha dash equals P plus Q cos alpha dash. This is the equation. What is this? This theta is resultant inclination by parallelogram law of forces, the standard equation. So now we just substitute the values. Tan inverse of, that is Q. Q value is 20 sine 60 divided by 24 plus 20 cos 60. Alpha dash is 60 degree. So determine theta value. What is theta value?
27 degrees.
See, we just observe that R is the resultant of inclination with respect to any one of the angle. So when we are representing with parallelogram law, we know that if this is Q and this is P, so R like this, and this is inclination with respect to theta. So with reference to this diagram, theta equals beta. So by this, we can easily say that theta, which is equal beta,
which is 27 degree, which is 27 degree. Now we require alpha. Alpha equals, what is the total angle? That is alpha dash. Alpha dash minus beta. Alpha equals alpha dash minus beta. So we can easily compute alpha value. Alpha dash is 60 degree. Beta is theta. Beta is very simple, it's theta. That is 27 degree. So what is alpha?
33 degree.
So this is the procedure to compute the interior angles of P inclination and Q inclination, that is alpha and beta. So we just used the direct equations. By using the equation resultant, we determine R square equal B square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos alpha. That is here in this case, alpha is nothing but alpha dash. Don't confuse. So these are just notation. Next, we know that resultant inclination equation, tan inverse of Q sine alpha dash. Why have taken alpha dash? Because the figure given, it has inscribed angle, whatever the angle between P and Q is alpha dash. That's why we consider it as alpha dash. So we determine the value of theta value. The theta is nothing but you just see this figure. That is resultant inclination between one of the force P. So that's why theta is nothing but beta. So once we this theta is nothing but beta, alpha can easily determine by whatever the angle minus beta, whatever the inscribed angle between P and Q. So that is 60 degree minus 27 degree, it gives the 33 degree. So it's very very important problem, minimum 8 marks problem. By using parallelogram law, we have to solve this problem. This is the computation of resultant as well as angles. Thank you.